Okay, so the third speaker today is Yaroslav Bazykin. The title is Non-Diffeomorphic Reflations and Modified God Beyond the IGES class.
Okay, so right. First of all, I would like to thank organizers for opportunity to give this talk, and especially to my co-author. And I need to say that there is some mistake, because this is only my affiliation, but of course Anton works in this University of Hradec Králové. And also, this is joint work with Pavel Gominyuk. So, okay, maybe it's better. Oh, yes. In the beginning, I would like to remind the definition of classical God Beyond the class. So we have three-dimensional manifolds, some foliation of dimension one with oriented bundle, normal bundle. And we can consider the one form which defines this foliation as a kernel. And of course, the integrability condition gives us this equation. So there exists one form eta, and God Beyond the class is the cohomology class eta d eta. And of course, we can choose different omega and eta, but this class is defined uniquely and correctly. And there are many papers devoted to this class, and up to this moment, it's not completely clear what geometrical meaning of this class. And I will speak about some modification of this class, and let me consider some very simple examples to understand what the difficulties and how it can be compared the theory of characteristic classes of foliation and the fiber bundles. So the first very simple example is Möbius strip. This is example of this is space is a fiber bundle over circle, and in the same time this is a foliation. So this is in this sense this foliation is not a fiber bundle, but the leaf space is orbifold, and so it's not so different examples. But the first non-trivial example is Kronecker foliation. So we consider two-dimensional torus, and this well-known action of real numbers with dense orbits. And if this fraction is irrational, then angle, but I missed 2 pi here, yes? Then this, if this is a rational number, then the orbit is dense. And if we try to consider the space of leaves, it's equivalent to the circle with a discrete dynamical system. We have the diffeomorphism phi, which is the rotation of this angle, and also the orbit is dense. And the problem is the following, that usually for usual serial characteristical classes, cohomologies, so the classes are in cohomologies of base space. But now the space of leaves is even not Hausdorff. So we have no continuous function, only constant. So the usual method is to consider some cohomologies of manifold itself, and consider, for example, forms which are compatible with structural foliation on some other constructions. And the first non-trivial example maybe is a reef foliation, and this foliation is of particular importance for my talk. So consider solid torus, the product of S1 and two-dimensional disk, and some function f. F is a, yes, this is function. F is an arbitrary function, even function, with domain to be interval from minus 1 to 1, and with these asymptotical conditions. I will say why these conditions are important. Okay, then we consider all shift, vertical shift of this graph of this function in this strip, and factorized by integer numbers. So we obtain such ring with a one-dimensional foliation. This foliation already is called ring foliation, but this is foliation on two-dimensional ring, but we need to rotate this along the mean circle and obtain this foliation in the torus. So we have in solid torus. So we have exactly one compact leaf, two-dimensional torus, and all other leaves are diffeomorphic to plane, real plane. And now we can consider two such foliation, refoliation on solid torus with two functions f and g, and glue two copies of S3 as usual along the common boundary in the such manner that parallel of one torus glue with meridian of other and vice versa, and obtain three-dimensional sphere. And also it's interesting to look at the space of leaves of this foliation. We see that the non-compact leaves on every solid torus gives a circle. So we have two circles. But compact leaves is some very special point, singular point, which is with the following properties: every neighborhood of these points contains all other points. So it's also non-Hausdorffic, and we have also this problem with the construction of some topological instruments. And okay, so we have the following situation, that we have one compact leaf, which is a two-dimensional torus, with holonomy, is not trivial holonomy. I remind that holonomy defined is as the following. We consider some curve along the leaf, some transversal in the point, and this curve shifts to some transformation of this transversal. And so we obtain the homomorphism from fundamental group of leaf to the transformation pseudo-group of this transversal. And we have the following two theorems. The first is that if foliation has no holonomy, then Godbion Weil class equals zero. And even more, it was proved by Mitsutani Marita Tsuboi, that if M is almost without holonomy, that also Godbion Weil class equals zero. The almost without holonomy means that only compact leaves can have non-trivial holonomy. So this is exactly the case of rib foliation. We have only one compact leaf with non-trivial holonomy, and so the Godbion Weil class, classical Godbion Weil class of this foliation equals zero. And now consider the following construction. This is construction of modified class, which the idea of such construction was, I think, firstly was suggested by Losik. So consider some transversal of foliation, and consider the space of two jets. So we can see the two additional coordinates in our case. So one-dimensional transversal U, tangent vector coordinate x1 and two jet coordinate x2. And the idea is that if we consider the transformation over this expanded space, then the leaf space becomes Hausdorff and the usual topological constructions work. And so, okay, we have some holonomy transformation. Of course, the transformation of holonomy gives some transformation of the space of two jets. And this is the explicit formulas for these transformations. And important remark that if we consider the volume form, then this volume form is preserved by every of such transformation. And now if we consider general case, so there is some foliation on manifolds M, we can consider some union of all possible transversals. And of course we obtain some set of holonomy transformations which generates pseudo group and then we can consider this space of jets which also can be glued each to other by these transformations. And after that, we can define the forms. So we say that omega is a K differential form on this space, if it compatible with all transformation from holonomy, from our holonomy. So we obtain Dirac complex and cohomology groups. And now we can define modified Gott-Biot-Weil lossy class, GVL. This is the cohomology class of this volume form on this expanded space, so on the space of jets. And yes, of course, we have these homomorphisms. In fact, this is a homotopy equivalence, so we have this homomorphism, and it can be proved that GVL modified Gott-Biot-Weil lossy class goes to corresponds to classical Gott-Biot-Weil class, and we know that, for example, for RIP foliation, this class is zero. But I will show that modified class is not non-trivial. So generally, this is not. Not injection. So we have some non-trivial kernel here. And some remark, because the question arises, maybe there are another such classes, that it's can be understandable that, one can understand that we have to consider the some transversal, ideal transversal R, real number set, and consider all diffeomorphisms as a pseudo group of holonomy transformations. Of course, topologically it's a point, but if we consider corresponding space of jet S2, then the cohomology is isomorphic to Gelfand-Fuchs cohomology of Lie algebra W1. It's Lie algebra of formal vector fields in R with respect to orthogonal group O1. Of course, O1 is just Z2 in this case, and the natural projection in the in this point space gives to us these homomorphisms. And in fact, the generators of these groups gives characteristic classes. Well, in some sense, it's similar to classical theory when we have some universal bundle with classified space and all generators of cohomology gives all characteristic classes. And on this, by this idea, we can consider S2 prime. So we factorize S2 by tangent vectors. So we kill all tangent vectors and obtain the space with two coordinate x0, x2. So x0 is its coordinate itself on the transversal, and x2 it's a coordinate in the space of two jets. And then the form tx2 takes dx2 dx0 gives another characteristic class, modified characteristic class, which called Chern-Losek. And the first non-trivial example of such a class was found by Losek himself, and maybe Anton said several words later about this. And but if we consider the same construction as above, so projects this class to classical cohomologies, we obtain zero, so always. So in fact, there are no classical analog of this class in dimension one, in real dimension one. And the theorem is that we have, if Chern-Losek class is trivial, then Godbion-Weil-Losek class also is trivial. Let's return to Ripf filiation. So, of course, this horizontal semi-interval can be considered as transversal. And what is the holonomy transformation? If you consider some x, then all integer shifts gives the image of this x. So we have f at of x, f squared of x, and so on. So we have some discrete dynamical system. Phi of x equals to this expression. And we obtain some diffeomorphisms of real line with one fixed point, unit derivative, and all other derivatives in the fixed point equals zero. This is follows from the above conditions for asymptotical properties of function f. And so, in some sense, we can say that phi is a diffeomorphism which is tangent to identity, and moreover, infinitely, the tangent of infinite order. And so, what now the problem of in such terms? What's the problem of triviality of Godbion-Weil-Losek class? We have to find some two form such that d of omega equals the volume form, and this omega is invariant with respect to these diffeomorphisms. And in fact, this is non-trivial problem for discrete dynamical system. And so the first result was that Chern-Losek class is non-trivial always. In fact, it's always non-trivial if holonomy transformation has a fixed point and this fixed point is not hyperbolic point. So there is more general results. And if we consider the question of triviality or not triviality of GVL class is much more hard, and the crucial property is that does it exist one parameter family of diffeomorphisms which include our phi as phi 1, and it's not trivial because we know that it's always so in the class in the smooth class C1, but if you consider some general case, that there are, for example, examples when such a phi that phi t exists, but smooth only for some counter sets t. So there is only some counter-like set on a real line for which phi t is infinitely smooth. In other points, phi t even not C2. But for reflation, it's this equation is simple because we can just set phi t of x equals this expression. So we just consider the shift on every t. And so what is the why it's very convenient to have this phi t? Because the invariance, the problem on invariance with respect to some discrete group, semigroup, we change to property of invariance with respect to some vector fields. This invariance with respect to field V, which can be expressed in this way. And V, I didn't say. This is the, yes, V is called the Zekeres vector field. This is the vector field which generates its one parameter group of diffeomorphisms. So we have this vector field lifted on the jets, and we consider such a particular case of Zekeres field V alpha, where alpha is arbitrary real number, positive real number. Of course, this field defines phi and defines a function f for definition of reflation. And we proved the following theorem that Gottbion Weyl-Losek class of reflation on the solid torus is trivial if and only if alpha is integer. So if alpha is not integer, then the class is non-trivial. And so if we have some alpha beta with integer and not integer, then corresponding reflation are not diffeomorphic. This was the first result. And the next result, we consider, so we expand this Zekeres field, which defined only for positive x. So this is only one solid torus. But if we consider another solid torus, then we, we consider the same field. So we continue this field on other solid torus and obtain the following theorem that, of course, alpha is need to be integer, because if alpha is not integer, then GVL class is non-trivial. But if we have odd alpha, then also GVL is non-trivial on whole three-dimensional sphere, on the foliation for whole three-dimensional sphere. If alpha is even, then this class is trivial. So it was very surprise for us, but there is such a result. And of course, this corollary that even and odd alpha gives non-diffeomorphic reflation. Okay, and this is the papers where the result were published, and maybe I stop here, and maybe Anton wanted to add some remarks here.
So maybe just a few remarks. Mark Osik was my first teacher in differential geometry, but fact then I worked with Dmitry Alekseyevsky in other direction. I didn't know much about what Mark Osik was doing. And just 2 weeks before he died in 2013, he wrote me that he was able finally to prove this result for the repopulation, that for arbitrary repopulation, what he called at that moment Chern class, is non-trivial. Then we generalize this theorem for more general populations in conditions that triviality gives. Just it is enough to have some holonomy transformation which has fixed point and which is non-hyperbolic. And in fact, what it gives, above Yaroslav told that there is some classical theorem, 2 classical theorems about trivialities. So, if foliation is without holonomy, then Godbion V class is trivial. And if foliation is always without holonomy, then Godbion V class is also trivial. And we prove also this theorem for the Chern-Osik class, almost for foliations. And now what we see? We see that rip foliations, they have non-trivial Chern-Osik class, and together with generalization of the theorem, it shows that this Chern-Osik class at least gives us information that rip foliation has compact leaf with non-trivial holonomy. This is first remark. Next, I got some handwritten papers of Osik, and he made a lot of attempts to prove that also this class that we call now Godbion V Osik class is non-trivial for arbitrary foliation. He made a lot of attempts. He failed to prove this, and for 3 years we also was trying to prove this non-triviality, and finally we realized that it's not the case. It depends on the choice of the rip foliation. So, and got this result that for some rip foliations this Godbion V Osik class is trivial, for some other it is non-trivial. So at least it allow us to detect this class allows us to detect non-equivalent or non-diffeomorphic foliations. Classical Godbion V class doesn't allow to do this, to say anything about rip foliation, because it is trivial for arbitrary rip foliation. But just we recall once more that first Chern-Osik class says that rip foliation has compact leaf is non-trivial holonomy, and this Godbion V Osik class allows to say something more, to say that there are some rip foliations which are not equivalent. This is all.
Thank you. Thank you to both. Thank you.